Good morning, students. Hope you all are doing well. Here I am your teacher, Snigdha Gupta. Today I shall be discussing with you a lesson from your class 9 textbook, Beehive. The name of the chapter is The Slate Isle of Inishree, written by the Irish poet William Butler Yeats. So before proceeding to the discussion of the chapter, let us have a background about the author.
William Butler Yeats was an Irish poet and playwright. He was born on June 13, 1865 in Dublin, Ireland.
He was one of the foremost figures of the 20th century literature.
It is said that the works of Yeats form a bridge between the romantic poetry of the 19th century and the heart-clear language of modern poetry. He won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1923. He died in France on January 28, 1939. So let us have a look at some of the contribution that Yeats made in the world of literature. His famous books were The Fairy and Folk Tales, The Countess Kathleen, The Wind Among the Reeds, and many more. He was also one of the contributors in the history of the modern theatre, which occurred in 1904 as the Abbey Theatre Company.
The poem The Late Isle of Inishree is a musical poem. This poem gets its title from a small uninhabited island, and this island is on the lake of Lochgill. Lochgill is situated in Ireland. This is the place where the poet spent most of his boyhood.
This place is very quiet, and that is the reason the poet wants to go there. He pens down this poem because he yearns for natural retreat where he will be living for peace. He pens down the poem because he yearns for a natural retreat where he wants to live in peace. Through this poem, the poet depicts the present hustle and bustle of city life with dirt, noise and pollution. And so he longs to go to Inishree, which is in the lap of nature. And that is why he longs to go to Inishree, which is, according to the Irish poet, a place surrounded by natural beauty, along with calmness and tranquility. I'll arise and go now and go to Inishree, and a small cavern build there of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for honeybee, and leave alone in the big loud glade. The poem begins with I, which he expresses to the poet William Butler Yeats. In this poem, he expresses his desire by saying that he will arise and go now. Means he will stand up and start his journey to the place known as Inishree. So in the next line you can see he's saying that, and a small cavern built there of clay and wattles made. Means when he'll arrive at Inishree, he wants to build a small cavern, which means a small house. Now this house will be different from us. He is not going to build a house of bricks, but he is going to build a house of clay and wattles. So what is wattles? Wattles are small sticks which we use to make the walls or the fences of the small house. Now, after he has a shelter to live, the next necessity that arises is food. So he says that he will grow 9 rows of beans near his room. Moreover, he also says that he wants to have a beehive for honey. He then expresses his desire through this line that, and leave alone in the bee loud gale. He wants to live alone by himself in the bee loud glade, which means it is a place, an open place where you can find only the noise, which means that the sound that is made by the bees. So we have seen in the first stanza how wonderfully the poet expresses his desire that he will live there alone, and he will hear is the only loud sound of bees, not the sound of civilization. So let us move to the second stanza. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the veils of morning to the cricket sing. There's midnight all glimmer and noon a purple glow, and evenings full of linnet's wings. In this second stanza, the poet gives us some glimpses of life that he expects to have in Innisfree. So, the poet says that when he will be in Innisfree, he will find peace. He says that the feeling of peace will be felt slowly and gradually. He then describes to the readers how he is going to find peace there. So, in the morning time, he says that when the surrounding remains hazy, hazy means when it is not clear, then it will appear to him that the morning has worn a veil and has hidden itself. So, what is the word veil? We know that the word veil is a piece of fine material worn by women to protect their face. So here the poet draws similarity of the morning with the veil of a woman. When he'll have such a vision, he'll find peace. Then he says that when the cricket, so cricket is an insect that is related to the grasshopper family, but with shorter legs. And the male cricket produces a musical chirping sound. Thus he says that when this insect, the cricket, will be singing in the morning, it will give peace to the poet. He will thus breathe calmness in the morning, and moreover he will also enjoy it. Next the poet moves to the midnight. He says that the midnight will have a glimmer, means the midnight will be shining. Then he moves to the noon. He says that the purple color light of the noon will also give him a sense of peace. In the evening, he says that he'll be fascinated by the linnet's wing. So what is a linnet wing? Linnet is a small bird which is brown and green color and it has a short beak. He says that when the birds will be flying in the evening, it will be a delightful experience for him. Thus we can come up to know that because of all these magical qualities of day and night, means all the time in Innisfree, inspires, fascinates the poet to go there where he will be surrounded only by natural beauty. So let us now move to the third stanza. I'll rise and go now, for always night and day I hear the lake water lapping with slow sounds by the shore. While I stand on the roadway or on the pavement's grey, I hear it in the deep heart's core. So let us move to the third stanza. I'll arise and go now, for always night and day. So in the stanza, the poet says that he will stand up and go to Innisfree because all the time the sound of the lake water striking the shore bugs his mind. This sound attracts the poet towards the lake. He says that whenever he is standing on the roadway or on the grey pavement, he hears the sound lingering. So what is pavement? Pavement is a path with a hard surface on one or both sides of a road that people walk on. So he says that he hears the sound in the deep heart's core, means he hears the sound in the innermost part of his heart, and for this reason he is driven to go to Innisfree to find some sort of peace there. So students, we can draw the conclusion of the poem The Lake Isle of Innisfree, as the title reflects perfectly what the poem is about. And curiously, the name of the word Isle contains the word free, which is what the poet is looking for. The only way to escape from reality for the author is through the imagination and the sensation that are deep in his heart. And this imagination and sensation is his place, the place where he spent a lot of years of his boyhood, and he yearns, he longs to go there, and that place is Innisfree. So this poem reveals the real suffering that the poet feels when evoking the images of his paradise. Paradise is his place, his boyhood place, Innisfree, in contrast with what is a hell for him, the city life, which is full of hustle, bustle, dirt, noise and pollution. So this poem draws a moral that as human beings, we need to escape sometime from the oppressive atmosphere.
atmosphere in which we live. So, if we cannot do it physically, we can always use our mind and heart to try to reach to this pleasure that we love. Thank you, students, for watching. Hope you like my session.